Hey Wastelanders, this is Gary, and I'm back for kind of a tag video that Mark Kaufman did, and I've been seeing going around to RJ's Knives, Jersey Knife Guy, and I don't know if anybody else caught on to the tag, but I wanted to do it. So, bear with me, this is kind of a tongue-in-cheek video, but it's somewhat serious because when I did go on vacation, I always took this gun and I took a very heavy duty knife. He's probably considering going on vacation flying, but most of my vacations are by the car, and thank God I've never had to be prepared for anything. But I believe in taking decent size knives or possibly a gun on vacation. I'll keep the gun under the seat in the lockbox, but I always take a firearm and a knife, and I don't worry about knife laws. So it's not only for protection, it's for a useful tool. And carrying a Swiss Army knife for me is not a very useful tool. So sorry traditional lovers and people that like Swiss Army knives. I like them. I think they're cute, but they're not a tool for me. Tool for cleaning my fingernails, what have you. But I prefer a medium-sized knife or a large size knife when I go on vacation. On top of that, I always take my get home gun. I call this my get home gun, and I didn't make this name up. I forget the dude that did. He has a YouTube channel, and he featured this HK USP on it, and he called it a get home gun, and it fits the bill because I've had this gun for like many years. I probably have this gun at least 20 years, if not longer. And this gun will fire any kind of ammo. I mean, it's rusty, dirty, muddy. This gun will fire it. I have no misfires using this gun. I fired some 16-year-old ammo in this gun, and it shot every round flawlessly. So this is my get home gun. Why not take it on your vacation? You know? So it's on safe now. There's no bullets in the chamber. Decock. So I carry this. This is a 17 round. It's a 15 round magazine. But I have plus twos on the bottom, so I carry an extra two. That makes it 17 round magazines. I believe I have two 20 round magazines for this gun, and I think I have a smaller magazine. I don't remember if it's 10 or 13 rounds. So I take at least four magazines on vacation. So that's my gun talk. On top of this, this goes with me every day, so it would go on my vacation anyway. So I can't count that because I carry a bag with a pistol in it with this knife. This is my backup knife. When I'm carrying I'm doing a carry, even a traditional knife, I always have this one knife on me. This is my backup knife. This is the Kershaw 0308. I call this the race bait 308 Mattel or Hot Wheels car, and I was named race bait 308, and I labeled this name for this knife. So I always carry this knife. If I was going on vacation, this knife would accompany me. It would be different like if I was going on a flight. I don't fly anywhere. I always drive. And I don't lead the countries. This would be a knife I would recommend going on a vacation with you. But I'm not going to count this because, like I said, I always have this knife. Oh, these will be five knives that I would take on my vacation with me. And you may find that silly, but like I said, I'm a different kind of person. I just don't believe in carrying a Swiss Army knife on vacation. I'm always alert to what's around me, and I'm always prepared for danger. So this is a knife that I would carry. I really like this knife. I recently, I don't know, 3 months ago, bought it. You probably have a better idea when I bought this than I do. But I bought the full size. What do you call it? The RSK, MSK, RSK, MK1. It's a Hoag Ritter. Yeah, I like this knife. This knife is appropriately sized to get the job done. I mean, defending yourself. So this is the, I would recommend this knife. And it's pretty. I think anybody would be the cop or had a problem. Like if you pulled this knife out and be dazzled by the scales and you're like, yeah, I'm going to have to let you go because these are some fucking nice scales. So my next knife recommendation would be something like this Real Steel Control. This is a fancy control, but I have a control that's in G10, maybe $60. This is over $100, maybe $150, $60. But, you know, if you want to go out in style, try this. It's an S35 VN steel, and it's a beast. You know, get the job done. So, the next knife, what if you feel a little light? You want to go a little light. Why not use the Hoag Deka? So, I like the Hoag. Oh. I like the Hoag Deka. It's a very light knife, and I like the Warncliffe version better than the clip point, but I have this. I have the other version too. This is a knife that's in 20 CV, CM 20 CV. I've used this knife a lot. I know it doesn't look like it, but the finish is very strong. I've cut a shitload of stuff with this. Just for the hell of it, let's see how it goes through this thick rope. Let's see if it still has an edge because, you know, I haven't sharpened it. Yeah. Yeah, it's still sharp. Woo, made a mess. Anyway, I would recommend this Hoag Deka. This is one, two, three, two more knives. You guys know, if you followed me in chat, I really love this Benchmade. This is Benchmade is the 818 Mini Loco. But I love this knife. If you're ever in a fight, I believe this would be excellent. You could reverse grip it, and you could just slash all the way, punch and slash, punch, slash. This knife is great. This is a fantastic knife. And I would give 100 bug outs over this knife. I like this knife. So, it was hard to decide on the fifth one. So, I'm on a vacation and a civil war breaks out. Who knows? It could happen. Or some kind of ruckus. Why not have a fixed blade in your car while you're going on vacation? So, I really like Winkler knives. And what better knife that you can have than the Survival Striker by Winkler Knives. So you can see Winkler knives, and it's made in the USA, good old USA. And it's the right size for your hand. It's not overly large. This is a great knife. So I'm going to recommend something like that, something like a fixed blade this size, similar size, very heavy duty knife. So thick. Let's leave it without the sheath. I'm going to recommend these five knives. So I had some runner-ups, and I'm not going to show you it because this video is already long enough. Well, I'll show it to you, but I won't say anything. This knife would be a good runner-up. This knife would be a good runner-up. Take care, Wastelanders. I hope this video wasn't like too corny or too stupid. I just had fun with it. Believe me, I'm not lying. I would take a big size knife with me, and I always take a gun. And I always travel by car, so knife laws are out the door for me. I feel like protecting your family and yourself kind of is more important than worrying about a 3-inch knife on vacation. Unless you're flying, that's totally different. If I had to fly, I would put my knife in my luggage. And I wouldn't carry a knife at all until I got to the place, unfortunately. Take care.